Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here. It's Thursday morning, and in this presentation, we're going to take a look at the New York Stock Exchange 10 most actively traded stocks from Wednesday's trading action. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are below fair value. We've got crude oil down for the sixth day in a row, and the Dow is currently down 85 points in the pre-market on Thursday morning. So we're expecting some selling on Thursday morning. Now we've got the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ both on daily sell signals. So we would just assume without doing any analysis that the majority of stocks in both of those indices are already on sell signals. Now we've got crude oil down for the sixth day in a row on Thursday, and gold is up once again in the pre-market on Thursday. So looking to take a run at the April highs. Let's take a look at those most actively traded stocks from Wednesday's trading action, starting off with Bank of America. Down at the bottom of the range right now, we've got an open gap that the market has dealt with, and so that gap is no longer in play. And so we'll look to see if the April lows can hold. Otherwise, 1250 is our next target to the downside for Bank of America. Now, yesterday was an inside day, but it looks like today is going to produce a lower low. We are looking for a close above 1429 on Thursday to give us a buy signal, and I certainly don't expect that to happen. And we've got an open gap between where we are right now and that upper channel line, and of course that upper channel line is going to continue to move lower daily. Stock number two this morning is Freeport, and we're projecting lower prices here down to the $7 level. Holding support at the flypaper channel at the moment, so that's a good sign. Look two lines down, that takes you down to 781. Look two lines up, that's back up to 1406 with an open gap in between. We are on a sell signal right now. We traded up through the upper channel line yesterday. We need to close on Thursday above 1115 to give us a new buy signal for Freeport. Next up, we're looking at Twitter, and Twitter slid along the bottom of the panic zones for a while, finding support at the $14.1406 level. We've moved up over the past couple of days. We gapped higher, looking to fill the open gap up there just below 1719. We're on a buy signal right now. That would change on Thursday with a close below 1471. GE is our next stock this morning, and currently ranked an 8 up at the top of the panic zones there. Look two lines up, that takes us back up to 3203 and the March high. Look two lines down, that takes us down to 2891. We're on a buy signal right now. That would change on Thursday with a close below 2997. Next up, we're looking at Chesapeake Energy, and we're in the middle of the panic zones at the moment. We are projecting down to the 250 level on the downside and up to 540 on the upside. We're stuck in the flypaper channel at the moment. We're stuck at the 50 and the 100-day moving average. We took a run up to the 200-day moving average and tried to break out above it. That didn't last very long. So here we are on a sell signal coming into Thursday's trading action, looking for a close on Thursday above $4.63. Regions Financial is our next stock, and we're projecting down at the moment, down towards $8. If we look at the price targets here, you can see $8 is way down here at the 781 level. There's an open gap that could potentially act as a price target on the way down. If we look two lines down, that takes us down to 820, so that's a reasonable trading range down there. And then of course look two lines up, that takes you up to 1016. That's our playing field for the next few weeks. We're coming into Thursday on a sell signal. Yesterday was an inside day. A close above 968 on Thursday would give us a buy signal. Certainly not expecting to see that happen. Our next stock this morning is Petrobras, and we're right in the middle of the panic zones right now. Trying to hold support at the flypaper channel. If the recent low is taken out, then look two lines down. That takes us down to 391. If we look two lines up from where we are right now, that's 781, and that's back to the April high. We are coming into Thursday on a sell signal. That would change with a close on Thursday above 653. Not expecting that to happen. Next up, we're looking at Synchrony Financial, and it got clobbered the other day. We had an early warning signal go off, and then we did have a sell signal. If you look at the flypaper channel chart, you can see that basically we've spent probably a month above the flypaper channel, maybe 5 weeks in the past year. So this is has been an unloved stock for a long time, and so we're just getting back to the norm, which is trading below the flypaper channel. There's the big drop that we saw the other day, inside day yesterday. Of course, we need to close above 3076 on Thursday to give us a buy signal. Not expecting that to happen. Next up, we're looking at Ford, and Ford's in the middle of the flypaper channel, trying to hold a 1289. If we take that out, then look down to the April lows as a potential target, and then 1211 on the upside. We can look a couple lines up, takes us back up to 1406. Not expecting that to get there this week. On Thursday, we need to close above 1328 to give us a buy signal. To get over, to start getting over that level, then we need to break through this open gap here. So just be aware of that open gap. Next up, we're looking at Whiting Petroleum, and there's the early warning signals going off. We're projecting lower prices down to $8. To get there, we need to go down two lines. That takes us down to 781, so that's a reasonable target to the downside. We are holding support at the 50 and the 100 day. Notice that we ran up and tried to break out above the 200 day and couldn't do it. And so now we're looking to see if we can hold support. We're sitting right at the 100 day there. If we can take that out, then that breaks us through the bottom of the flypaper channel, and then a move back down to the February lows would not be unexpected. Of course, the market could turn around on Thursday, and a close above 1302 is needed to give us a new buy signal. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Looking for lower prices on Thursday. If your stock is not already on a sell signal, expect it to join the rest of the market over the next few days. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.